Back with me this morning is James Wilson from Alchemy Resources. James, good morning.
Good morning to you, Andrew.
James, you had this news towards the end of last week here, a tenement win in the recent ballot. Tell us a bit about it. How does the ballot work?
Yeah, when we applied for the license about 6 months ago, there was multiple other parties that apply at the same time, and you've got a certain time frame of a window to go and do that to contest that. So sits there for a few months, waits for everybody to get to the position, and then basically the mining registrar draws names out of a hat. It's that simple. And Alchemy was drawn first in that instance, and it was a great result. We're actually having a bit of a history of winning ballots, winning 3-3 last year as well. So we're very confident going into it that we might have a chance. So great result. And the tenement sits in proximity to our neighbours at Global Lithium Resources and proximity to the Cardunia granite, which is a good thing too.
Well, just to build on that, tell me a bit more about the significance of this new area.
Yeah, it sits just to the north of Roe Hills or our Coroni project. So it's a consolidation of what we already have up there, and it's next to what we already have. It's about 24, 25 square kilometres. It's a reasonably sort of small footprint, but it covers granites and mafic rocks, which is all the right kind of rocks you want up there. It's also within that Goldilocks zone that we talk about, which is within a 10-kilometer range of a nearby granite that we think is fertile, which is the Cardunia granite, which we think is potentially controlling everything in this region. So yeah, very exciting part of ground. It does build on what we already have as well, and it's certainly a big consolidation of ground that we've got up there at Coroni.
And as you say, you've got some fairly well-known neighbours in the area.
That's right. Global Lithium Resources is right next door, and they're currently drilling out their Manor project, which is very exciting too. So it's a new area. That's the only deposit in the region. We're finding anomalism all around us at the Cherry and Hickory project as well down the road, and also regionally as well. So it's a very exciting development that we've gotten. We're just building on information as we go. So it's sort of starting to look like it's a new province by the looks of things.
And so when do you hope to be on the ground here?
Well, with the tenement that we just won, we've actually got to go through the rights negotiate process and all the usual government approvals to go and get that across the line. And once that's done, we'll get on the ground there. In the meantime, we'll be drilling at Cherry and Hickory in about 2 weeks or under 2 weeks. So it's just when the drillers are available, and we'll be drilling out the Cherry and the Hickory primary target there that we've been talking about for quite some time. So that'll be particularly exciting and very much a sliding door moment for the company, I think.
Good to speak, James. Thanks very much.
Great. Thanks, Andrew.